Hey. How you doing out there? How you feeling? Are you feeling safe? I had to talk, I talked to the millennial?
Yeah, they're out there.
I was having a talk with the millennial yesterday, and the amount of times this dude said, "Feel safe."
What?
Yeah, dog. Like, yeah, and, you know, it's a lot. You know, just feeling safe in the work environment and safe, and just, you know, just like it was fucking crazy the amount of times. Talk to a college grad young person and listen to how many times they mentioned safety. It's fucking crazy. You're just like, what? Yeah, you know, just safer that way, and just, you want to make sure they're feeling safe, you know.
Safe space.
Yeah, it says this meeting is being recorded on my thing. Yeah. Is it always being recorded?
I'm getting ahead of the game. Sometimes I forget to record it.
Okay.
Do you not want me to record it?
No, I don't give a fuck. It just, my Zoom popped up and said it's being recorded. I was just like, all right, let me do that shit. Yeah.
Can add this to the file.
Yeah. Jude's talking about millennials feeling safe. It was just so like, just want to make sure that they feel safe. I'm like, from what? Like what? Missiles or getting punched in the face or like what? What the fuck is gonna happen to you at work? You know?
Do you feel safe?
Yeah, I don't even think about that shit. Like, I know when I'm in danger. How about that? Like, I know when I'm in danger. There's been times where I'm like, where I'm walking through a fucking sketchy neighborhood and I can feel like I'm a target. Or I'm at a red light and I can feel someone peeping the fucking car. Some shit like that. I can feel where I'm in a situation that could go bad, but I don't walk around like my natural feeling is like, all right, dude, I'm good. Like, I'm not in a super dangerous neighborhood. Like, I'm not in Chirac, dog. Like, I'm over here in fucking the suburbs. So yeah, I perpetually feel safe. So unless you're in like some crazy fucking war zone, like, I would imagine that you should probably feel safe. And we're talking about in the workplace. They're like in corporate America, like, of course. The worst is gonna happen. The boss is gonna hit on you or something. That's a nice blouse, Susan. Oh, you did your hair today. Good.
Oddly enough, Ike out of Chicago, he's felt unsafe at work.
What does he do, though? All right. Ike.
I work for the city of Chicago.
There you go. Well, Ike works for the city of Chicago. So, and what was the situation where you felt unsafe, Ike?
I was actually on my lunch break, and almost two years ago, they tried to carjack me, and I got shot.
So that was my right arm. Yeah. So would you compare that to somebody using strong language around you to make you feel unsafe, or what? On a scale from 1 through 10, 10 being the highest, you almost being carjacked while eating lunch. We'll put that at 10. Now,
but
somebody using
part about it, you.
What's that?
Things I was right outside the job.
Where in Chicago were you?
I was on the south side, right outside the Metro parking lot.
So you was
right
on the south side
of the library.
All right, you was on the south side, and you almost got carjacked on the south side of Chicago.
And did get shot.
And got shot at. I didn't get carjacked. I almost got fucked up on the south side of Chicago doing Jenny Jones shit, where they brought me and the cameraman out, and a bunch of, like, Vice Lord cats came out and had us surrounded and made me tell jokes. And that could have gone bad. Lucky for me, they knew who the fuck I was, you know what I mean? But...
Let me just say this, Juke. I'm finna actually walk back in the job, but I understand what the people saying with the cursing, because like I say, I deal with customer service all day long. Yeah. And sometimes you want to smack the shit out of the people, even though they talk to you disrespectfully, and as much as you respect them first. But sometimes that can really make you feel away. It can really make you want to be pissed off when you get off work and going home.
Yeah, does it make you feel unsafe? That makes you feel angry.
No. I actually typed in the second part of why you were saying to call in, and see, let me call in before I walk back into the job about the unsafe. But that being shot definitely would make you feel that way.
Yeah, get it. So yeah, there you go.
Agreed.
I agree too. That's what I'm saying. I think it's bullshit for somebody that's in some fucking cushy fucking corporate job talking about feeling safe while Ike is out here getting his window shot out. And they're trying to put that in the same category. It's not. It's not the same category. Ike is getting his window shot out. Someone just didn't fucking put something, set a word that you didn't like.
Yeah, I think Ike's living in a different generation there. I don't think he's really exposed to a lot of safe spaces on college campuses.
No, he's working for the city.
Yeah.
He's working for the motherfucking city, dog. It's just live out there. Yeah. But it was just crazy. Just listen to that shit. Like, you know, listen to things that they repeat over and over again. And that's what's been programmed into their brain.
Well,
when
I have
you're
to
talking
ask,
to these youngsters.
Why are we hanging out with this person? Who is this person? Talking about safety.
It was just, I just happened to be at like a fucking, like, a family thing, and a friend of the family was there, and they just started talking about some shit, and I was just like, all right, cool.
I see.
Cool. All right. Sweet. And it got to, but it's, they said it so much that it came to my, I was like, huh. Like, I'm gonna pay attention to that, and I'll have other people pay attention too. Cause I feel like everybody wants to be safe instead of like fucking just do their own shit and worry about that shit later. I feel like everything went downhill as soon as they started making kids wear bike helmets.
Have you ever cracked your head on a curb? It fucking hurts.
John, you're pedaling fucking, you're going like, first off, you're old as fuck. Secondly, I wore a bike helmet too when I went through the streets of Los Angeles.
Yeah.
These kids are wearing helmets and fucking in the parking lot, going around in a circle, and like everybody know that kids, their bones are like kids are meant to fall. Like our bones are all brittle and shit. Kids are like way more resilient than us. And they do have special car seats that are like, they did come up with like a whole new car seat for like fucking 7-year-olds. And people buy them. I've seen them firsthand. Fucking gay as hell, dude. I'm just saying, doing shit like that plants these weird things in people's head to make them like turn them in, like just slowly turn them into bitches. When you're constantly worried about your safety. Like, if you don't feel an imminent danger, you're pretty safe. That's the way I look at it. I'm even trying to think of it was uncomfortable with Rick Ross. I had an uncomfortable interview with Rick Ross. I didn't feel unsafe, but I felt like they were like, it was uncomfortable. It was before it came out that he had been like work for the prisons and shit like that. And I was like, tell me about how much were balls going, like how much was bricks going for and shit. And he was getting mad when I was asking him about coke. And then since he was getting mad, all his whole squad was getting mad because at that time we would just let 20 motherfuckers in the goddamn studio at once. So it was like me and 20 people. And I'm asking him questions about how much a kilo costs down there. And he's getting upset. And I'm not saying he never flipped him. I'm just, because, you know, just because you're a prison guard doesn't mean you can't haven't done dirt. I actually know prison guards that fucking was doing dirt too. So there.
I think you're going to have to define what you're talking about when it comes to being unsafe, because people are calling in with, like, being assaulted at their jobs all over the place here.
Well, that's let them on. Like, I want to hear that. That is unsafe. Like, yeah. Let them on. Let them on. Who else?
Me.
All right, what's your name?
I'm Char from Toronto.
Char? All right. Well, what do you do?
I work at the hospital. I was a supervisor for one of the surgical departments.
Yeah.
I felt pretty safe at work. My work is one of those floofy workplaces that, you know, no tolerance, safe space, everything, all of that.
Yeah.
And I never had a problem. Always felt safe, walked everywhere around the hospital. Until one day I was just doing my job and the frickin' plumber comes in and literally whacks me on the ass so fucking hard, it shook my whole body.
So, yeah, that would be sexually assaulting you or sexual harassment at the fucking workplace. So yes, that would fall under him putting his hands on you in were you guys alone? I'm guessing.
Was I alone? No, I was talking to another man.
Damn, and he came and smacked you?
And he came in right behind me and wound up and whacked right in my ass.
And what'd the dude do? What'd the guy do, who you were with?
Well, he was shocked. He just, like, kind of stood there with his mouth open. And then he was like, ow, that was really loud. And I was just like, what the fuck? And then the other dude just kind of, like, made a joke, picked up a newspaper, giggled, and walked away.
So were you scared? Is that the your first thing?
I was
fear?
Just shocked. I was just like, right. What the fuck? Did this motherfucker just hit my ass at work? And then I didn't know what to do. I like he walked away. I went back because it was shift change and I had to be there. And then I freaking finished my shift, went home, and was like, what the fuck do I even do? I didn't even know what to do because I was still in shock. I couldn't believe that happened.
That's when you go holler at the fucking HR. Like, hey, I just got smacked in the ass by the janitor. Apparently he didn't get the email about fucking no booty grabbing. Give me another one.
Let's go with Vinny in North Hollywood.
Hey, Vinny in North Hollywood, go ahead.
What's up, Judy?
What up, though?
So... we're talking a couple of years back when I was 19. I was a little more skilled on the computer than the manager at this company. And the only reason he was still there was because he had sales experience and I was still running the computer and shit and starting the day and running everything. So this motherfucker ends up grabbing asses and slapping bitches' asses just like Homegirl was just talking about. Probably so hard you can hear it. And he gets basically let go and shit. So once he gets let go, I'm the only one there to run this shit. So I move into the role of manager.
Okay.
So like a week later, this motherfucker's like, yo, I want to come in here and get some money that one of the people who work for us, one of the telemarketers, owes him, which is like $10. And I'm like, bro, you can't be coming in here bugging him while they're at work. You don't even work here no more. Me and this dude used to ride into work together. Like every day.
Oh my god! Long story. So then, what happened?
I'm coming there.
Well, you're coming slow. You're a slow comer.
he comes in there, shermed out of his mind, trying to collect $10. And this dude's 6'4", 54 years old, and I'm 19. I'm like 5'11". And this motherfucker just lays the largest fucking haymaker while I'm not looking. Sucker punch. I got it on camera, bro.
So that's
destroys my whole glasses, everything.
Okay.
Took me out.
Damn, that's so you being assaulted at work made you feel unsafe. That fair enough. Fair enough. Once again, that doesn't fall into I guess that's my whole fucking point. For a whole group of people to try to compare their fucking someone using the wrong word experience with you getting fucking punched in the face by a 50-year-old fucking sherm head that used to work at the company, put that in the same book is ridiculous. It's not even the same fucking library. It's not on the same page, not same sentence. It's not the same. Give me a decent, let's just end with one last one.
All right, I've got Chris out of Chicago.
Chris, out of the shy.
Out of the shy. I work at the Cook County Jail on 26th in California in the Men's Maximum Security Division. Mm. And there have been many days that I have been extremely nervous for my safety.
I imagine so. Give me one for instance, just so people can understand.
Real quick, the inmates have microwaves, right? And I'm telling the inmate, look, dude, you got to get your shit out of the microwave. It's time to lock the fuck up. They don't want to listen. They think I'm this pristine, prissy, librarian-looking white girl. And they're like, nah, we're not going to give up the microwave yet. I'm like, yes, you are. So he won't take his shit out of the microwave. So I'm in my head. I'm like, Lord Jesus, I'm about to bend down and unplug this microwave. Please don't let this dude knock the fuck out of me while I bend down and unplug the microwave, because I can't let him punk me, because if he punks me, then he's going to punk. They're all going to punk me all the time.
Right.
So I bend down and I unplug the microwave and I said, now get your shit out of the fucking microwave and lock the fuck up. And, you know, the whole time I'm just praying to God that this dude doesn't knock the fuck out of me.
Yeah.
And of
so
course
that's
he didn't, but.
That's another legitimate reason why one could feel unsafe.
Yeah,
having to put yourself in a vulnerable position with somebody that you're with a inmate that you're arguing with. So
absolutely.
Yeah, once again, would you compare that to John saying the wrong word to you in a conversation? I don't think so.
No, I think she's living in a different reality than our
yeah.
It's the
bourgeois. It's the bougie motherfuckers that write the articles and tell you what the fuck to think.
But
think
even,
for yourself.
They're even around here. Certainly some of the interns. Ho, ho, ho. Man, oh, man. Some of the conversations I've heard around here about.
I know, Doug. Like.
I mean, I just walk away like, how did she get here or he get here?
It's like, yeah, it's like, I would not let any of these, like, this is a fucking live radio. Ooh. Fucking, like, how did you get a job here? Like, nope.
Keep that guy away from me. Fuck.
I know. All they are, they're some fucking X amount of dollar, there's cheap labor that can get you fucking in trouble. That's what interns have become. Like cheap labor time bombs. We've had cool interns.
Danica.
All right, who kids here? Let's play a song. We're gonna play a song. We've been wanting Who Kid. We're getting fucking Who Kid. So play a quick song. We'll be back with DJ Who Kid.
Listening to the All Out Show with you.
True. We got on DJ Who Kid.
What's up, man?
Everybody been asking for you. They're like, we want Who Kid. Yeah, you're the most. You're our most popular guest.
For real, I'm so fucking. I'm so happy, man. I'm so flabbergasted, yo.
Yeah. Across the board, you are the most popular guest.
Damn. Oh, man. That means I'm doing something right, right?
Yeah. You're like hot sauce. You go on everything. Like, fucking everywhere. Across the board, you're winning. So I was like, we should probably get him more. We should probably get Who Kid more since he's super popular. And John's like, man, I try, but he's always on the run.
He's on the run.
That guy's always on the run. He's dipping everywhere.
It's a little difficult because even I had to cancel a few interviews because when you're on a tour bus, the Wi-Fi, as you know, you've toured with Eminem before.
Right. Like,
the Wi-Fi is just horrible, man. Like, that shit, like, you can't do Zoom on a tour bus. You could download a song or anything like that, but when you're trying to do video interviews and audio stuff, it's constant, like, glitches and pausing. And so I would rather just be like, nah, I can't do it because, you know, I'm a nigga, and niggas is always late. You know what I'm saying? When it comes to, like, tour buses and scheduling, it's not a professional schedule, you know? So when you act a little niggery, you can't tell a corporate company, yeah, I'll be there. You know, I'll tell another nigga that, you know, yeah, I'll be there. But I'm not going to tell you because, you know, you represent Shade 45, Sirius XM. And I can't be niggery with, you know, Rude Jew. You know what I'm saying? So I'd rather respectfully wait till I'm speaking, you know?
And plus, it's loud on the tour bus, and the fucking it's if you've been on the tour bus, it's 12 loud dudes, dog. Like, it's just you can't get fucking anything done, and they're arguing over what to watch and shit, and it's
and
just fucking
who's shitting the
fucking thing. No one's supposed to shit in the fucking thing. What was that?
Nah, there's a generator that's constantly on. It's just like if I'm talking to you, all you hear is it's like a hermaphrodite wet in the bed or some shit. It's just like so I'd rather just wait until I'm clear so I can give my boy the best show, you know what I'm saying? And today I'm in Kansasville, Wisconsin. So somebody tried to give me I don't know what that is. Somebody just tried to sell me G. What is G?
If someone's trying to get me their phone number, get the number. I need that shit. I'm dead ass. That's my favorite shit, and I can't find it out here in Michigan right now. So get their phone number. I need that shit, bro. Like, for real. Get their number. Tell them to fucking hit me with a giant with G's across the board so I know it's them. I've been trying to find that shit forever.
What is it exactly? I don't know what it is. I thought maybe
it's you take a little bit of it and it's fun, and then a lot of it is that with that whole fucking J-Lo movie was about, where they was robbing the dudes.
What? You get some hallucination type issues with that drug? Or
you knock out and just fucking, you knock the fuck out and you're like, psh. You mix that with alcohol and knocks you out, and they fucking, they rob the fuck out of you. Yeah.
He was charging me $25 for it. Is that a good price or?
Yeah. Ask him, does he? I need it. I fucking need that shit. Fuck yeah, dude.
Is that a Midwest?
Nah, it's like, bodybuilders, gay dudes, and fucking sex workers use it, all for different reasons.
What?
It's a low calorie way of getting fucking pumped.
I've never heard about this drug until I came out. Because I'm out here in Wisconsin. I was in Iowa, Nebraska, Minnesota, North Dakota. I didn't even know people live in North Dakota. Like, this G thing coming up. It came up like almost 4 or 5 times on the road. Like, yo, you want some G? I'll get you some G. And now this fucking crazy white guy wearing FUBU. This guy got a FUBU fucking onesie. I don't know where you get the shit from. You know those jean, what do you call them shits? Farmer John jean suits or whatever.
Overall type shit.
Yeah, like but it was a FUBU one.
Yeah.
I guess because I'm Johnson, FUBU is still popping out here. I don't get it, but he had like pockets full of G. He's like $25 before you do your event tonight. I'll hook everybody up. You know what I'm saying? I'm with Riff Raff too, so I guess maybe because I'm with Riff Raff, he's assuming he's gonna sell like crazy drugs. So I don't know.
Like, yeah, I feel like people think Riff Raff does more drugs than he does, but Riff Raff seems like he's more sober. Like, I was gonna say, I was like, Riff Raff seems like he's got his shit together, and people just think he does a lot of drugs.
His fan base, they definitely do drugs because they're coming in the events dressing like Elvis. They look like him. They got mullets and shit. And you know me, like I said, I'm a little niggery. I'm just not into like all this eclectic shit. Is that eclectic in your world? Like, well, what kind of white people are those that become riff raff?
Those guys are hype beasts. Like, they're like white hype beasts, bro. Like, and like, don't act like black people haven't started wearing fucking dresses and shit and fucking weird nail polish and rocking fucking t-shirts of bands they've never listened to that were pop white bands from the fucking 80s they've never listened to, like Bauhaus and shit. You're like, the fuck you don't know about them, bro? Like what are you doing right now? Why are you wearing one high heel and one tap shoe with a fucking dress on and a Bauhaus shirt? Like, what's going on with you, man? And you got a fucking gun. And you got a gun on you. Got the strap.
Is it the environment of being out here in these weird-ass towns the reason why black people have to convert? Because I was at Hot Topic. I was picking up, you know, some hip-hop tees or whatever. That's where I bought The Weeknd. I really like his tee, so I went there to get it. But I saw like a black guy with like spikes in his hair, and he's buying like heavy metal, like tees, like groups he never heard of. But I think he thinks it's cool just to buy it, just to be cool, just to live around here.
Yeah, I think like perping is cool now. Like back in the day, you couldn't perp. Like if you was rocking. If I was like rocking a motherfucking Run DMC shit, they'd be like, what's the first Run DMC album that came out? Da da da. Like, you'd get quizzed. If you wore some shit, prepare to be quizzed on your shit. And if you didn't know it, you was perping like a motherfucker. They get your ass. Man, get the fuck out of here. You don't know shit about that shit. I don't even know the, like, off the top of my, what is it, King of Rock? I don't even know off the top if I could answer that shit. But like, I've even seen it with motherfucking with brothers. Like I Rap-A-Lot did some shit with Supreme, and I'm like, oh, I didn't know that shit. So I saw a guy, he was a Supreme fan, black dude, and I'm like, oh shit, bro, you got that Rap-A-Lot? Oh dog, I was excited in the motherfucker. And he was like, you could tell, you know that face motherfuckers make, like the smiling, you caught me cheating face. I'm like, what's that Rap-A-Lot shit that you fuck with? And he's like, you know, like the Ghetto Boys. And I'm like, who else? He's like, you know, my mind's playing tricks on me. I'm like, oh, this motherfucker, he don't know shit about it. Like, get the fuck out of here, bro.
Nothing, man.
I was like, Jay Prince, right? He's like, yeah, right, yeah, told, yeah, told, yeah, that's, yeah, that, that's what's up, Jay Prince, exactly. I'm like, yeah, okay, I'm gonna walk away before you melt.
My experience in this while I've been in the Midwest in a while, all these weird ass states. Starting next month, I'll be doing the regular joints, like, you know, Vegas and Miami and all that crap. But why is it that it's 80-20, is like 20% sexy chicks and 80 and maybe 90% crazy fat chicks in these venues? Like, I'm just like bugged out. Like, where are these fat? It's like a influx of fat chicks buying tickets now. Like, and then obviously
they eat like shit out there, bro. They just eat like shit out there. They eat horrible.
Know, like, and they're ready. Like, they're in the tour bus. Like, I don't even know how they get in there. And then,
it's like the air, when you get on an airplane, it's like the hottest chick on an airplane might be a fucking five walking down the street. But since there's only 90 people, that's your 10 right there. You're like, that's the baddest bitch on here. Some chick with a club foot and a fat ass, but you're like, fuck it, I'll take it. She's the baddest chick here. She's got a nice smile and a fat ass.
I'm not gonna snitch on, you know, the individuals on the tour bus. So the way you will figure it out, you'd have to go on my Instagram to figure out who fucked. Well, multiple fat chicks got fucked in the last couple of days. But the fact is, you know, tour buses, those bunks are like mini coffins, you know? So to fit like a good chick that's like 220, 240 in there with you, sitting on top of you, riding you in that bunk, and you hear a fart, and I know it was her. I know it wasn't my boy. You know what I'm saying? I was disgusted, bro. Like, I was like, yo, I don't even know what the fuck is going on. I was calling my ex-wife, trying to get my ex-wife back. Like, that shit just got me delusional.
What have I become?
Bro, and I know it was wet. And you know how tour buses are. Once you shut that door, it's the air conditioning. It's mossy. It smells like swamp. Because, you know, like six motherfuckers is sleeping in them bunks, sweating with AC. And now you're going to throw a fucking 280-pound bitch in there, riding a skinny-ass nigga. I already snitched on that. Riding a crackhead skinny nigga. That's the homie. You know what I'm saying? I don't even know how she got in there and rode him, but I know for a fact that shit sounded wet. That shit came out long. It wasn't even like a quick fart. It was just like a wet.
Was her pussy rate farting or her booty was farting?
It was her booty, not the pussy. It was like I heard, excuse me. Like, I heard the word excuse me. I walked out.
Motherfucking. You could tell, yo. But like, yeah. The other thing is some guys just like fat chicks, man. Like I remember when I fuck fatter than most white dudes. I'll tell you that much. As far as my fat scale goes, I fuck fatter than you, who kid. I fuck fatter chicks than you do.
I mean, I have none against fat chicks, but it's just, I just couldn't understand like how easy, like, it's supposed to be easy, but it was almost effortless. And she had horrible clothes on, no fashion sense, and she looks disgusting. And number two, the fart thing is just too much for me. It makes me like think differently about touring. It makes me think differently about groupies and whorism. Like, it switched up my whole like meaning of the word whore. Like, it just was disgusting. And my man kept going too. I guess he wanted a nut. He didn't care about the wet fart. He didn't care about, you know, the disgusting thing going on in there. And, you know, when you slide that fucking, that drape, and you can hear movements, and it's like a snail. It's like a caterpillar or some shit in there. Like you ever, I don't know if you ever heard a caterpillar on the Nature Channel. They'd be filming them walking and shit, and they'd be like that weird ass.
Yeah.
I don't know if I'm turning him on over there. You look like he's getting turned on. Your co-host over here. You look like he's getting turned on. I can't get that shit out of my mind. You know what I'm saying? I can't even get hard right now. I gotta get back to New York. I gotta watch like unlimited orgy porn to get back into the mix. And I have to be by myself, like for like 2 days. You know what I'm saying? But it just was bugged out to me. This Midwest run is just out of control. Iowa, Nebraska, North and South Dakota, Minnesota. Now I'm in Kansas City, Wisconsin. Tomorrow I'm in Logan. I don't know.
You don't like broke motherfuckers. That's what it is. You just don't like broke. You don't like broke motherfuckers. Duke doesn't like. He doesn't like the working poor. He's like, fuck them.
I don't get it, man. Yo, Sunday normality. You are always on my Instagram. This Sunday I'm at HQ2 Pool, Atlantic City. There's gonna be 5,000 white bitches there. That shit makes sense to me. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't get it. You know? Next week I'm with Snoop Dogg. I'm at Live. You know, Miami. Live, me, Snoop Dogg. Then I'm doing that Ozark pool shit, which I think you should come to. The Lake of Ozarks. They finally booked the nigga. I'm there on the 12th. So that's what I'm saying. Like, those make sense. But this shit out here, like, I don't know, man. Like, yo, mentally, I'm gonna think shit over.
But bro, they all spending. Like, why you shitting on them? They all got money to spend. They're coming out there to see you. Yeah, you got. Yeah, he's holding a bunch of hundreds, a whole stack of hundreds, and he's still shitting on them because they're not cute enough. Because the people that gave him the hundreds aren't cute enough. You fucking, what a dick, what an asshole. So thanks for your money. Now, why don't you cut back on the fucking casseroles? Put the meatloaf down.
Yo, I ain't gonna front. They gave me a phone, you know, what do you call it? A money phone. You know how the rappers put that shit next to their ear? They actually gave me one. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they do. You got a money phone.
And it's not go to like Lil Durk. I look like a little dick.
I don't even know what Lil Durk looks like to tell you if you do or you don't.
Oh my God. You know, he's like one of the top artists out there, man.
It's
crazy. Like, this guy's like number one out there, man. He just dropped his drum.
Sure, he's fucking awesome.
Yo, man.
We got a gang of hip hop shows on here. It's like I don't want to be there's little Durk. He's got like braids. He doesn't look outlandish. He's just got braids and he's got, you know, some. He's got some diamond chains and he's talking into a stack of hundreds.
He gets all
amazingly as expensive as those money phones are, the service sucks. You can't get on the Wi-Fi. You can't upload your pictures on Instagram. You got to use a different phone to upload that same picture. The money phones suck. They look good though.
Because of your show, I'm gonna do a money phone photo for my Instagram to promote your show. Man, how do I look? Does it look good? Do I look like Lil Durk?
Yeah, you are. Yeah. Y'all got the same hairline now. Yeah, it's fucking. Y'all got. You just got to grow out some little twists, and you'll be fucking golden. You'll be fucking.
Son. Are you into all the new guys? Are you into like Trippie Redd? Who else? There's a whole bunch of little guys out there that's cracking. What the fuck does fucking Rude Jew?
Bro, I was listening to fucking jazz and shit for the last fucking. I was listening to like fucking Roland Kirk. I was listening to jazz and shit.
You don't listen to like 42 Doug, you know what I'm saying?
He's from the city, but nah. And no disrespect, I'm just like, I just, man, I'm fucking like, we I don't, have you listened to our show? We don't really talk about rap too much. We bring on other motherfuckers to talk about rap. Yeah, so it's just like,
I'm just being curious.
There's so many shows on here that talk about rap. So why do you need me to? I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, nor do I care. So like, I'd rather talk about fucking fat chicks. I think there's a lot of upside to fucking fat chicks. They try harder. Fat chicks try hard than a motherfucker. They put in effort, man. They're gonna suck your dick. You want to get your dick sucked? I didn't say they're the best at it. My best blowjob hasn't been from a fat chick, but they'll try. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? They will put in the goddamn work. You see, they work the bag. They're like,
my boy's in when she took off her pants. It looked like a fist, like a plump. Like he couldn't even describe it. Like. The pussy looked like it was like, when you taste like pepper, you'd be like, the pussy, pussy, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's so small. Like, you think, like, a fat chick would have a big pussy? You know, he's like, he couldn't even get in that shit. She was like a virgin. I was like, what? So he made her sit on top of him. So at least it feels like. he's in something. You know what I'm saying?
I was talking about this shit a couple weeks ago. This girl, I fucked this real fat chick, and she was like, "Oh, you're gonna need at least, I need at least 8-9 inches," and I'm like, "God damn!" And then I go to fuck her, and that's because her labia is so fucking fat. Her outer pussy is like 4 inches of fat that, like, by the time I get to the hole, I lost 4 inches. So, you know, like, she's only taking 5 inches of dick, really. You know what I mean? Like, my first 4 inches was just the outside, like, just getting through the outside. My last two reached the boss. You know what I mean? Like, I'm finally playing the game. I'm not even like I just started playing the game. Like, this is ridiculous. So yeah, that's why you need all that dick.
It's like layers. It's like you're going through the stratosphere, and you're going through like, you know, like different joints to get to Earth, and you just never got to Earth. You never landed.
888-742-3345. Why do you like banging big girls?
It's the ongoing question right there. Ongoing.
When I first got out to Cali, it was before fat asses were popular. It was like Money Train had dropped, but like it was, you know, like it was kind of bubbling, but not really. A lot of anorexic chicks. And I was so used to Michigan where it was like the girls were thicker, and I was just like, I can't deal with this. Like, so I started fucking, I got my hands on this ex heroin addict that like was like all skinny, but gave up heroin. So she got fat and shit. And, I would take her to Cheesecake Factory and fuck her afterwards and shit. It was, and I remember my cousin came down to visit and was looking at me like, "Bro, you're like on TV and shit. Like, what are you doing fucking this girl?" Like, and I'm like, all these chicks just look fucking anorexic, bro. Like, but now I'm older, and I'm going to tell you, I like pussy in conversation. If the pussy's good and the combo's cool, like, we can build from there.
Well, let me make it clear that these were Midwest fat chicks. These are not cute ass fat. There's beautiful fat chicks in Atlanta, Miami, New York. I mean, I'm talking about where I'm roaming through LA. And then yeah, there's some beautiful fat chicks. Yeah, I would hit. I'm not gonna lie. I'm talking about the ones that have no fashion sense. They're wearing, I don't know, they got dirty ass Abercrombie on. The shoes are bending. Like, they got like penny loafers that's like shit, like a flat tire. I don't know. But my boy is dirty. My boy's a dirty piece of shit. He ain't get pussy in 3 days on the tour, and he still hit it. You know what I'm saying? And I just couldn't believe that he hit it. And it was not a hot fat chick. They have chicks that's sexy. Yeah, I guess.
Was she the hottest one there, or was she just the most worst down one?
Like a piece of crap. Like, and she had like two. You know, you see one, there's two other ones. But
right,
I didn't think it was gonna go that far until I went to the back of my laptop. You know, I always hide my laptop and my jewelry case like deep in my bunk, and then I'm hearing these weird caterpillar wet moving sounds. And you know, everybody's curious on the tour. If you know, if 50 Cent's fucking some bitches when I'm back in G-Unit, I used to peep through the fucking, you know what I'm saying, I want to see why my boy tearing that pussy up. You know, they used to do that with me too, you know. It's just curiosity. You know, so if your boy, like, you know, like Tony Ayo, Lloyd Banks, whatever, they fucking like five bitches or whatever, you just gonna peep through the door, you know, and watch, you know, bitches sucking, going crazy. So that's the groupie life on the road. But if you hear like a fucking caterpillar sound and it's wet, and then, you know, you hear the moaning and all that. So I started getting curious just to see who my boy's fucking. And I realized it was the big, ugly, disgusting one. You know what I'm saying? Not the other two she was with. It's three altogether. So there's always one medium girl, and then there's always one girl that just has no ass. Like,
you don't feel like you outgrown? Like, I'm like, I feel like I've outgrown. I've really never wanted to peep in on other motherfuckers fucking. Like, maybe when I was 18. But I got to a point where I'm like, I'm just too old to see new dicks of motherfuckers that I know. Like, I don't.
I I'm not, you gotta see him from the back, like, just hitting the bitches, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know,
you open the door, it's a crapshoot. You don't know what the fuck you're gonna see. You're like, fucking.
And you never know. You might be invited. Get a look. And I've been in that position where they invite me, yo, come in and get this who kid. I'm like, what?
Be right there. I just happen to have one on me. Here I come. Yep.
You never saw like Bizarre fucking some bitches and then you just got curious and then he let you in to fuck the bitches with him all during the D12 shit? Like, or you know what I'm saying?
Yo, real talk, like I'm gonna keep it 1 billion with you. Like, my game was Trump tight where I was just pulling bitches and just taking them off where I wasn't having to share. I wasn't sharing with nobody. I was spitting my own game, fucking them on my own, and they were over there tossing chicks up. I was like, all right, you toss them up. I got a fucking bad Navajo. I want to act a hoe, so let me fucking do that shit to the fullest. That's some real ass shit.
You're gonna tell me that you never like joined, like you were part of like a legendary rap group. You don't have to snitch on anybody, but
yeah, but I mean, who kid? Who kid? You was part. Look at it like this. Like it's a big thing. Like who kid? You're like G Unit. You're at the party. I'm Jude. I'm Shade 45. I'm valeting the cars. It's not. We're not even in the same. Like, I'm not even in the same fucking atmosphere. Like, it's not like I'm sharing bad chicks. It's like I'm getting, you know, I'm on the tour bus with dudes that goes and gets coffee for bosses and shit. That's who I'm running fucking trains with. Like, I'm like, no, I'm good on my own. I'm gonna go solo. Like,
yo, but my experience touring with, you know, God Bless the Dead, like, you know, the whole D12 Cat Proof and all them, everybody was cool. Everybody was accepting. Everybody allowed you to hang with them. It wasn't like there was like blockades where, nah, this is our shit. Get the fuck out of here. They were very welcomed. I've toured all over Europe, you know, Spain and all that crazy shit with Eminem and the whole clique. And I thought because you're with them, it would be more welcoming for you. That's why I would ask you that, you know, because, you know.
I wasn't with them is my point. I was like 8 tour buses down. I don't even think I saw any of the main acts during the motherfucking shit. Like, I think I caught like 50 Cent in the hallway or some shit like that. And that wasn't planned. I just happened to fucking be there and grab his ass. Like, that's like, yeah. They were like, yeah, whatever. Fuck you, man. Like, I'm about to go fuck a bad chick. Fucking radio guy. Go back to your show. I'm like, okay. So I stopped. I was like, yeah.
You never had a rapper take your chick on the road? Like, I remember, I mean, it was rough for me in the beginning, but then when I started getting more famous, it slowed down, and then the chicks kind of like stayed more with me. But in the beginning, you know, Lloyd Banks and, you know, 50 was like taking everybody's shit. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, that's just,
But it's rules of the road. You know what I'm saying? That's like rules of the road. You have to accept the fact that whoever's the A-list apex in the clique that's like everybody's coming to see gets dibs. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah,
you got to, you know, I fell in love a few times and then the love was crashed when they just like leave me, like I'd have dropped them a dime for the, you know, the main guy. And I've DJed for countless other people. So that's how I know this rule is universal, because I've toured with Capone Noriega.
Yeah,
my DJ on the Bad Boy tour. I mean, I was a total loser. Everybody took my whore. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, I'm gonna take it like one step further on like some like when countries go to war, and they were like, oh, all these women got raped. I'm like, I don't think they got raped. I think they just was like, oh, these motherfuckers starting to win. I'm gonna go over here and start hollering at these women. Cause I've seen bitches dump a motherfucking dude over bottle service. You know what I mean? Like, it's like the same with you. Like, you over here, you handcuffing a chick for fucking 3 days straight, and motherfucking 50 walks in, and in 5 minutes, she's fucking gone. Like, Nah, these chicks, they know pecking order. They know they want survival of the fittest. They want their seed to live on. They're like, all right, that motherfucker's winning more than you. You're fucking to the curb, and I'm going up over here. That's, I don't have proof, but I just see behavior, and I'm just like, if they do that there, why wouldn't they do that over there? No, I'm down for my man, even though they getting their ass whooped. Nah, that's, they flipping the script.
Oh my God, man. I just wanted to put it out there that the rules are still the same on the road. Like, it hasn't changed. Like, and I think
so. Who's got dibs? Riff Raff's got dibs.
Yeah, really, you know, all the bitches are chasing him. You know, this is his world. Right. I'm literally in his matrix right now. Yeah, I got some bitches that know me from the Shade 4-5 radio show, shit like that.
Right.
But, you know, I need to get back to the Who Kid shit. You know what I'm saying? So it's all good. Like, I teamed up with him, and we're doing like some eclectic drug using album. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just like on promo run with him and getting paid at the same time from these ugly people and shit. But I'm just saying,
what a dick.
The rules are not changing. Like,
let's go to phone call. Tina's mad at you. Go ahead, Tina.
Yeah, DJ Who, what's up with you talking shit about the Midwest and fat girls? Like, you act like you're in a whole nother world. You're talking about you ain't never seen a black dude with spikes. Come on, if you're in California, there's all kinds of black dudes with spikes, and I'm pretty sure you won't see nothing but skinny bitches out there, fake ones. And here in the Midwest, we got real thick, pretty mixed bitches. So I don't know where you're at, but Minnesota and Wisconsin and North Dakota, like, I don't know where you're going.
Well, he's in Kansas City. What's the name of the town that you're in?
I'm in Kansasville.
He's in Kansasville, Wisconsin, so perhaps it's a different level of chick.
I was literally just in Wisconsin. Like, it's not different. I mean, it's different in certain places, but it's not that big of a deal. Like, and then he's just talking about all these fat bitches. Like, there's thick bitches, and I don't know what skinny bitches you're talking about. Like,
Tina, Who Kid is spoiled? He's used to going to, like, the fucking most hardest to get in fucking places where they only let fucking tens with no personalities in and fucking... I've seen him. He gets like three of them and stacks them up like pancakes, butt naked, and takes pictures of them and sends it to me. Like, look what I did. And I'm like, sweet.
But I did shout out that there's beautiful fat chicks elsewhere. I'm talking about the ones, the experience that I had.
God.
I want to make
could
it clear.
Could it be Riff Raff's fault?
The way you're coming off, though, it's like, holy fuck. Like, who the fuck do you think you are talking about all these fat bitches? Like,
I'm talking about the ones on the bus that was on the bus. And I did clearly say that I know cute, fat bitches everywhere on the regular states that I room. I said Atlanta.
You're saying he's still shitting on you.
Giving you my experience of what I went through. I'm not generically saying all the bitches are ugly here. I'm just telling you what happened on the bus. You know what I'm saying? They were horribly dressed. They were fat. And I just wanted to get some clarity about my man fucking a disgusting fat chick. I'm not talking about all fat chicks are disgusting. I'm giving you an experience of like the last four, five cities I went through. Iowa, North Dakota, South Dakota, Nebraska, Minnesota, and we were in like these little fucking towns, and I'm bugging out on the like continuous experience of the similarity of like seeing the same kind of chick like coming in front of me. That's it. I'm not.
Yeah, and these motherfuckers, they fly over state, they broke and shit. Like, what the fuck? All they got to do is eat and smoke Newports, man. What do you want them to do?
I'm not dissing human beings, yo. I'm just giving you my experience of what I went through, and I'm just trying to find some clarity. Like, somebody just tried to sell me G. I don't know what the fuck G is, you know?
So, well, try to buy it next time, or get his number next time. Next person that tries to sell you G, tell him to fucking DM Jude.
Yo, I apologize if I got you pissed off, but I was not talking about all the cool fat chicks in America. I'm talking about the experience of the same shit about, that
he's talking about the small town fat chicks in the flyover states that disgust him. There it is. Who else we got?
Let's go with Jay in Miami.
Jay.
Hey, yo, yo.
Yo.
Hey, I love being a fat bitch. You're...
Yeah, I hear you.
Give us a reason.
Fat bitches, they be dripping. You know what I'm saying? The bitches be dripping. Hey, take that bitch out to eat. That bitch, ooh, wait. She gonna eat, boy, boy.
Yeah, I heard that fart thing. Is that normal? Is that normal? I heard that fart and it was wet.
Boy,
during
eat that
sex.
Fart, boy, I eat that fart. That ooh, wait. You got to taste it.
You got to taste that shit. That was your problem. Who you didn't taste it?
I love me fat big boy. I tell you.
How big?
Are you going to marry one? The end of your romantic existence will be with a fat chick. You're going to marry one.
1,000, 2,000 pounds, boy. That's how I deal.
Damn, he wants a real big. Damn. He's like, don't get the dump truck. I got you. Hold on a second. Fuck.
Yo, he got me like more.
2,000 pounds. They can't get out the house. They can't even roll over on their own.
Bro, when he said he was going to eat the fart, that shit just like got me like bugged out. I'm not eating at all today. Like, I'm done. You know what I'm saying?
It's late in the day. It's you're in Central Time over there in Wisconsin.
Yeah.
He's fasting. He's fasting for the rest of the day after that. 888-742-3345. We got Who Kid in the Midwest, and he's having a great time talking about fat girls.
Got Roy in Missouri if you want to talk to him.
Why are you body shaming? Why are you body shaming and making them feel unsafe? Roy.
You, kid, yo, what up, my Jeezy? Yo,
what up?
So, I agree with you, bro. Like, yeah, back in the day, I used to have the energy for that, but not no more. What I'm going to tell you right now, though, like, high percentage, I get off on, like, coming on bitches' faces and swallowing and shit. Fat chicks do that automatic, yo. So that's been my experience from back in the day, But I'm married now. My wife 150, so I don't fuck around with no bitches more than 150. Because if you're bigger than my wife, I don't need it.
So there you go.
Yeah, I mean, it was great because you lost your virginity.
Matter of fact,
you lost your virginity.
Okay.
Go ahead.
That's funny. Yeah, you're right. I did. That's crazy.
Okay. All right, and then what were you gonna say?
So. Oh, you about to have an excuse to come out there, yo. I can't, because I ain't bringing my wife out there. I'm going to be out there, though.
When? In Atlantic City?
Nah, you said the 12th Lake of the Ozarks, right?
Oh, yeah. You want to come to that? Yeah, DM me. I got you. Yeah.
Oh, we out there. Yeah.
Oh, I got you.
There it is.
You know what I'm saying?
Like... 888-742-3345. We got DJ Who Kid.
Man, I ain't get nobody mad. I'm just talking about my.
You hope you don't get. You hope you didn't get anybody mad. You just fucking shit on a whole fucking region. Repeat, not like once, but just repeatedly. I'm sure they understand. I'm sure they're quite understanding of that shit. 888-742-3345.
Got Maurice in Indianapolis.
Go ahead, Maurice.
Yes, sir. This is Maurice. Yeah. I'm a 300-pound, 6-foot and some change. I only mess with little bitty women. I'm from the Midwest. So, you know what I mean?
Well, that you have
like
to.
You like what you like. I don't have to, though. I can. I'm long enough to mess with a big girl, you feel me? But
no,
hey,
I'm saying
like
the bed
slim.
Couldn't handle it.
Shit, yeah, huh? Mattress firm, fam. Come on now.
Yeah, fucking two 300 cats, 600 pounds, fucking... Y'all gonna break something's gonna get.
Even when I was a younger dude and I was a little dude, you know, smaller, yeah. I still like slim. It's just something about that slim. You know what I mean? I like slim with a fat ass with a bubble. Never dated like a big girl.
The yin and the yang. The yin and the yang, right? It's like the yin and the yang. Man.
Yeah, like what you like, man.
Yeah, you know nothing wrong with that.
But the big girls be getting the slim dudes, so hey.
Yeah, you see that a lot.
I don't mind like big girls and shit like that. I was just talking about like I heard weird caterpillar wet sounds and a fart, and I thought that was a normality, and it just fucked my head up. You know what I'm saying? And the visuality of the person not being fashionable, bummy, dirty, and this shit went down. That's it. You know, it's a combination of that.
It was the perfect storm of disgusting hoo kid, basically. And he's from Haiti.
I still didn't get an answer for that. I thought Jude would help you with that. Jude came to help me with that.
Like, I did. I told you. I told you. Your man just like, there's only a certain group of people. And if there's only a certain group of people, and everybody's ugly, like the cutest ugly girl is going to be the hottest girl there. That's how it goes. So yeah, you take her to your world, this bitch is a fucking dog. But like right now, compared to everybody else, she's all right. You know what I'm saying? She's like, she's a little above average. So he's fucking her. That's it. Like I guarantee, if you would have took that same girl and y'all was in New York, he wouldn't have looked at her twice.
Man, let me make it clear, man. I'm an ugly nigga too, man. I'm just like, I don't care about being ugly. I'm just talking about my experience. I'm not bigging up myself. I'm not better than anyone. I am a ugly nigga. You know what I'm saying? I'm just telling you what I saw. I'm just trying to make this clear. You know what I'm saying, Rude? Because you have a lot of listeners. I don't want to be getting attacked by like crazy chicks when I leave here. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you're gonna. You don't want to. There's gonna be some. There's gonna be some fucking thick women, bigger women, and especially now that they're doing like the body positive movement and shit, putting like bitches that ate at Cracker Barrel three meals a day for 2 years straight in underwear and throwing them up on like giant billboards and shit. You're fucking fucked right now, dog. The body positive motherfuckers are coming for you. Luckily, I don't think we got a ton of body positive. And like I said, I like all the girls, but like.
Well, you know, the Rude Jude Show has nothing to do with body shame. We always talk about realistic experiences.
Fuck body shame. Yeah, we are about body shame too. Yeah, we're about all types of shame. Like. Take it how you if you want to eat all your feelings and who kid can talk about how he feels about that and we have real conversations here.
It's hard for me to go around the bush and give you a cinematic answer like some fucking politically correct shit. I'm just telling you what I went through. That's it. And I'm on my way. I'm out.
Yeah, speak your truth, bro. Just speak your fucking truth, man.
You want me to fucking lie? You're like, yo, my man fucked the baddest bitch ever yesterday, like, and she farted, like, I don't know.
Was you clowning him?
Yeah, we were killing him, yo. And he had, like, his shorts was, like, some weird stain on it. I don't even want to go that far. I'm not even going to talk about the stain. I'm going to leave the stain out of it.
There's been clothes I've had to throw out after I fucked a chick before. Like, I'm just like,
that's bad.
Something bad happened. Yeah, I fuck a subpar chick and some weird shit will happen on my clothes. Like,
bad. She might have like a yeast infection or something.
Yeah, I can't deal with some of that shit. There's been times I'm just throwing it out.
Was it like a smell? Did you put it to your nose?
I remember someone gave me a Jordan t-shirt, a brand new Jordan shirt, and I had period sex on top of that shit, and it just fucking ruined it. It made that shit look camouflaged, and I just threw it out. I was like, can't even do it. Can't even do it.
Was it like thick? Like, was the blood thick, or it was like
watery? It was early.
Oh my God!
It was like pretty early. So, yeah, Savage. I just fucking yanked out the tampon, threw down the Jordan shirt, and just fucking went in. And then I was like, yeah, that's got to get thrown out. That Jordan ain't make it.
Holy
but
tomato
paste. But I ain't feel that bad because, you know, I'm a Pistons fan anyway, so.
Holy tomato paste. Jesus.
I do appreciate his game. He's the greatest ever, but fucking... fucking I'm not wearing a period stained shirt, a period stained Jordan shirt. Fuck that. Go ahead.
I remember that happened to me when I was fucking my ex-wife. The Chinese spots, those cleaners, they have period detergent that takes that shit off. It costs like $30, like $29, $29. I don't know why it's $29.50, but give him 30, you know what I'm saying? And then it takes
mentally people react better to the fucking 50 cents off. It's fucking crazy. Rochelle wants to hop on. Go ahead, Rochelle.
Cool kid. Hey, you are so fucking disrespectful. I'm not a fat chick, but talking about fat chicks like that, that's disrespectful, because if you weren't cool kid, you're not even a 10, and you wouldn't even be getting pussy like that.
I know that. I just said that.
Yeah, not at all. Like 5 at the best. So putting fat chicks out there, it's not a cool look.
I mean, I try my best to talk about the experience. I just gave you an experience. I ain't talking about every fat chick. I just told you why.
Yeah, well then you should probably start your conversation off like this.
No, I didn't.
You should probably start your conversation off like, hey, this is my experience with specific fat chicks at this time. Like, you're like, oh, you know, it's a fat ass friend, a medium friend, it's a friend without an ass. Like, that's some ignorant shit. And you're like a 5 at best. And just hook it. If you weren't hook it, you wouldn't get fucked.
But I'm not insecure about my 5. I'm cool with it. I'm just telling you what I saw. I don't know. What do you want me to do? You want me to lie and not tell you what I saw?
I don't want you to lie. I mean, you just say, this is, no, you... So that wasn't your experience.
All right, so you tell me, how would you say it? How would you say it, though? If you saw that, how would you say it?
If it was me, I'd say, this is my specific experience with this specific person. This is what I saw.
That's unfunny.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to be funny.
I'm not trying to hurt anyone's feelings either, because the fat chicks are going to come for your ass.
Yeah, that's
but I'm not talking about come. I already shouted out that I'm not talking about the cute fat chicks that I know. This chick was like realistically ugly. She had no swag, no gear, and she got fucked. That's the only thing I talked about. I'm not talking about all fat chicks in America. That's the problem. I don't know why you're going crazy. I did not say that clearly like that. And if I did, then I'm a piece of shit. But
woman, or just right, because she didn't
all right,
have
man, I, yo, all right, there we go. All right, see, both of you, it's now we're in a circular argument. Yeah, you guys are repeating yourself.
It's like a full 360. I didn't say that, and I made sure after.
Okay.
I gave you my experience.
Little kid, you don't
yeah,
have.
Yeah, I don't need to.
You don't have. She said her part. You said your part, and now we're gonna move forward. And you also have a. Somebody like myself who will fucking knock down a big girl. I'll knock one.
Yeah, I'll knock one
the fuck down. But who gets just spoiled? Who gets spoiled? He's like 20 years in the game of all tens. He sees a person fuck a 7 and he's just mortified. I don't even send, I don't take pictures of girls that I fuck with. And then every now and again, if I do, I'll send. I'm like, all right, I'll only send the ones that Who Kid would have sent me. They're like, so it's very few and far between. I'm like, here's Who Kid will send me 8 and I'll send them 1 back. I'll be like, here's 1. Check out this.
I'm not insecure about myself. I know I'm not perfect, and I'm just talking about.
The other thing Who Kid is like, she's like, yeah, you're just Who Kid. It's like, yeah, you worked hard to be just Who Kid. You put in work, time, hours. You on the fucking planes. You out here ripping and running, being fucking Who Kid. It's not like you're not paying the cost to be Who Kid. Like, you're grinding. Like, yeah. It's like, that's a grind to be you.
I already admit that I already admit I'm an ugly nigga. I don't know what more you want me to do. Like, you know.
I know. It's basically three ugly motherfuckers right here talking about women. John's not talking, really, but he's ugly.
I'm average.
John's not talking, but he's ugly.
I've got a look.
Yeah, John's an ugly motherfucker, man. That motherfucker like Igor or some shit. Like,
look at an average white guy. What's wrong with that?
No, you ugly, bro.
I see.
Like, I don't understand why you're this ugly, but yeah, you're ugly. Like if a man tells you you're ugly, you're ugly, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I'll make a note of that.
Like, if you were like in the medieval times, they'd have you working in the dungeons. You know what I mean? Like, that's. You during this pandemic, you'd have been picking up the dead bodies in a wheelbarrow. That'd have been your job. That's how you look.
Bro, man, it's so crazy. Like, you know, if you talk realistically, the buttons you press. This is the society we live in. We live in this big ass vaginal planet that we can't really, like, we gotta watch what we say. Like, you know, I'm just telling you what I saw. I didn't diss like a whole group of people. So it's like when you speak the truth, it hits home. Some people get pissed off because they're going through it. Oh, that's yo, bro. I'm not. What do you want me to do? You want me to lie and go around the corner? You didn't even tell me how she would say it. You know, she's talking. She wanted me to say names. Did I say any name? Did I shout out who it is?
Yeah, I don't even know them. Yeah, comedy's gotten tough. If you start playing by their rules, it's a wrap. You're just not even funny no more.
Like, you get like fucking like comedians. I was talking to Dave Chappelle. He can't even like, you know, he's like the most politically like dude saying some crazy shit. But even he told me he gotta like calm down with some of that shit.
I mean, shit, I did. Like, yo, I was like, I used to keep that shit 100, and then it went to 90, and then it's to 80. Now I'm keeping that shit 50. You know what I mean? Like, I keep it 57%.
Perfect. I'm over here giving you a basic experience, and it became political and emotional and like connective in like 10 seconds. Like, how is this one thing that I went through three? It's just like I went through three things, but the one thing really got me disgusted. I'm just telling you, this one disgusting moment. And you make that one disgusting moment become a reality for everybody in America. Like, you can't be serious, yo. I'm just telling you what happened in this small ass town, and I'm trying to get an answer for it. And that's it. Keep it moving.
Fat chick in an Abercrombie shirt farted real long, and Who Kid was stuck in the bunk next to it, and it bummed him out. It hurt him. A piece of him died inside, and now he's just telling you about his experience.
What the fuck?
You can't even tell a true story no more. You can't even tell a true story.
I'm gonna start saying some fake ass stories, man. Motherfuckers is straight vaginas out there, man. It's just wet vaginas crying all day. Fuck out of here, man.
Yeah, and the other thing too is like be proud of whoever you are. Don't like whatever Who Kid's opinion doesn't form the world's opinion. It's just one man's opinion. So like they're entitled to it.
An opinion. It was an experience.
Your opinion was you thought it was disgusting at the end of the and at the end of the story, which you found it disgusting. Yeah, that was your opinion.
You wanted me to say I smell strawberries and bananas and it was cute. Like, that's what you want me to hear from a fart. Like, maybe that'll make it calm. Oh my god, all our farts are like bananas and strawberries. I'm glad he said that. Get the fuck out of here, yo. I was telling you, I brought you into that fucking tour bus, and I gave you the smells, the senses, the like what I saw in my eyes. Like, rude. It's like you were in there. It's like you were in the bunk. You know what I'm saying?
Look, I don't want to talk to that. I don't want to talk. Like, let me talk to dudes that like smashing fat chicks. Like, I'm not trying to have fucking Who Kid arguing with every fucking woman in goddamn America over this shit.
Nah, it's
turn
okay.
This into the fucking argument thing, the argument hour with fucking Who Kid, because some fucking chick in a Hollister shirt fucking farted. Like, I just can't. I just fucking can't, dog. I can't. It's Friday, man. It's fucking Friday.
Bro, man, yo, it's Friday. I mean, it's hot out there. It's 90 degrees. You know what I'm saying? It's like mega hot out there. You know what I mean? trying to make your show hot today, man. Your show is super hot. Look at him. He can't even keep up with the phones. Look at John. Look at John. He don't know what's going on. Yeah.
Well, I do have Kevin out of Whittier. You want to talk to him?
Okay, Kev.
Yo. Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, go ahead, Kev.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, yo, shout out to the All Out Show. Jude, like, your show was the best, man. They got to give you a raise over here, man. It's the only reason I keep the whole SiriusXM radio. Like, who kid, you're the shit, too. Hey, yo, let me tell you about the big girl. It's the big girls, I, over 150 pounds, like, this butt must have been the best head I ever got. Talking about, like, you could do so much with the big girls. They got the big titties. Like, you could touch their tummy. You could tuck their dick, like, any way you need to. You could get, like, off any kind of way with them. Sometimes with small girls, they're just too big, and they'll be like, ah, that hurts. It's like, damn, man, I need a big girl. She got extra meat, so when I put my dick in, then it's like, yo, I'm going all the way in, and she ain't even tripping, like, you know what I mean?
There, I love this guy,
he's
man.
Saying, he's saying, there's an open-mindedness that's, that bigger women have, he's saying, which may be true.
So he'd rather have a big girl.
I guess he.
What's up? I don't know what, like, just push him to the phone.
There it is.
Damn.
See, the upsides of big women. 888-742-3345. And then some of these cats are, you know, getting gear and shit like that, having their SoundCloud shit, their SoundCloud studio time paid for by these big ass chicks and stuff. So there's that level of the game as well. There's that level of the game. So that hasn't really been discussed. The financial benefits.
Is that a stereotype? That's really a stereotype. Like, they pay for like studios.
What? Oh, bro. Like, yeah. Like, where I'm from. Like, I'm Pontiac. Back in the day, yeah. That was fucking. That was par for the course, man. That cast my homies that just have a fucking big one to fucking pay for shit and then be fucking like banging chicks too on the side, but they would keep a big chick for shoe purchases. Cell phones weren't really out at the time yet, so it was like shoe purchases and fucking and like pagers and shit, like pager bills, shit like that, you know.
How about the casino? I always see, like, you know, those couples that be at the crap table, or they be at the blackjack, and then they just coughing up the chips.
What kind of couples? I don't the skinny guy, like, the big girl,
like a big chick and a skinny dude, like, but it don't look like they're dating. But
and who's doing the gambling?
The dude's doing the gambling, but she's putting up the money.
There you go. The same deal. It's that same shit. It's like fucking crazy. I know. And yeah, and everything's different, but there's all these different levels to this shit. Everybody's in it for a different reason.
Yo, man, that's why your show is so raw, man. The truth comes out. People can't handle the fucking truth, man. What the fuck?
I know.
And it's proof.
Yeah, it's crazy. When it goes.
You can't even give an experience, and then the experience can't be like compared to, like, you know, you're gonna get your own answer for it. The shit gotta be like, oh, he's saying that's for everyone. I mean, you go do that shit all the time. I know you go do that shit. You had to chill. You're a bigger piece of shit than me.
Yeah, I totally am. But I'm also fucking pretty. I'm super open minded too. I'm like you're a pussy snob. So I piss off less chicks. I fuck all, like, I'm banging all the girls. I don't give a fuck. As long as you can put together a sentence, you know that you can figure out what the theirs are, like there, like in the DMs. I'm like, I can't be fucking a complete idiot. Other than that, you know, we're pretty fucking good.
John looked like he got some experience in that area. What's up, John?
There've been a couple ladies who may have been a little bigger, little heavier.
Have they done things for you, John?
I can attest that if you want to get right down to it, you might want to go in that direction. That is just an absolute fact.
Yeah, he did. John was driving Audi to work. This is how John got. John actually, if it wasn't for a fat girl, John wouldn't get the job.
By the way, a lovely person, lovely person.
John was working. John was driving an Audi into work every day and working all the fucking time. And it turned out that it wasn't his Audi. It was the fat girl's Audi. And he was staying at work so he didn't have to be around the fat girl when he got, like, the whole fucking thing was just John using a fucking fat chick and not wanting to deal with her fucking ass and staying at work to avoid her. And I'm looking, but I don't know any of this. So I'm just like, oh, this is a hardworking motherfucker. Look, he got an Audi. He's doing good. He's fucking grinding. Like, he's always at work. Meanwhile, that was not the truth. It was just him using this fucking big chick and avoiding her.
Just to be clear, that's a very one-sided view of that story.
Yeah,
there's some shades of truth.
She was abusive. She was abusive to John. John got abused by her, like, and shit like that.
It was a rough ride. It was a rough ride, man.
John was in an abusive situation, but he stuck around. He kept the car for a while. Yeah, yeah. John got abused by the fat chick. Yeah,
but she was down to fuck. That's an absolute fact. And I did not deliver on that front and often enough for her.
Yo, it's crazy watching cats. It's crazy. There's different levels of, like, I got some of my homies, like, when they're like playing a girl, they're not taking shit from them. It's like pimp style shit. And then I got other homies that are more like that. They're not as close, and they're more like John, and they're just like, they'll fucking get abused just to fucking stick around and get that free meal at the end of the night, at the end of getting cussed out.
You make it sound like I was completely cuckolded by this lady. That was not going on. It was a difficult relationship. I mean, it was...
All right, sure. That's okay. The way you call it. Call it what you want.
You get violated, like they punch you and stuff like that, like you get hit.
I've been punched once by a lady. She socked me, and yeah, that did happen. But it was not like a sexual thing. She was fucking pissed. She gave me a nice right cross.
Damn.
Yeah. I don't know. She was angry. What can I do? I piss people off once in a while.
All right. Let's get some positivity on here. 888-742-3345. We got Who Kid.
I've got Midwest. I've got Rita in Traverse City, Michigan.
Yo, Rita.
Yeah.
I have been a plus size woman, well over 300 pounds for the majority of my adult life, and I want to let Who Kid know that I ain't mad at you. I get what you are saying. There are way too many YouTube tutorials out today to be walking around looking like an ugly fat girl.
Yeah, I'm not talking about like the part of being fat. Is just the swag list. She had horrible, dirty clothes, fucked up shoes, and she, boy, still fucked her. I did not.
Yes.
You know,
here's the other thing too, Who Kid. Here's something else, Who Kid. She wore that outfit on her most important night. So imagine what she's wearing on, like, just on a Wednesday. You know what I mean? Like, she wore that outfit to go see Riff Raff. Like, what is she wearing on a regular day if that's what she's wearing to go see Riff Raff? Dirty Abercrombie.
And think about this, Rude. What if I said it was an incredibly skinny, crackhead-looking chick with horrible clothes? Now I would have all the skinny chicks coming at me. Oh, you're talking about skinny chicks? No, I'm telling you why.
You'd get a pass on that. We fucking murder meth heads all the time and get a fucking pass. Yeah. it's open season on meth heads. We haven't had one person being like, why are you clone? You know, like, that's like a mental problem, and you know, like, they can't help that shit. Like, we haven't had one of those calls yet, ever.
You know, but think about it. If I went like, yo, the skinniest bitch route, blah blah blah, now I would have every skinny chick in America talking about, oh, you're talking about skinny chicks. Nah, I'm telling you, this chick was not a pretty fat chick. There's pretty fat chicks out there. And with swag, they got money, they know how to dress. And I'd be like, all right, girl, you know, like, do what you got to do. But I'm telling you, some disgusting shit that happened, and the girl happened to be fat. And that's it. It's very simple. When I talk to Jude, I tell Jude exactly what happened to me like the night before. I give him my real experiences. I'm not degrading.
Thank God, because I'm not leaving the fucking house. So it's awesome that you're having some real experiences. I'm barely like getting out. So there you go.
So there you go. Like, if it's a midget, I have every midget this to me. If it was this, I don't even know if you say midget. It was a little person. You can't say shit no more. Like, if it's like a super dark chick, now all the dark chicks want to curse me out, or I'm a five. This, I don't care. I don't care what I am. I'm just telling you, and I didn't even fuck this bitch. I'm just telling you what I saw, what I smelled, what I heard, and how I ran. Like,
what
out the room.
What it smell like?
Smell like, I'm told you, like, you've been on a tour bus, that weird air conditioning, mossy, mixed with that wet, whatever she let out. I don't even know if it was a fart. It was like, it smelled like it was like acidic mixed with chemicals, and I don't know, man. It was like a horror movie. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. And then it just happened. The chick was fat. That's it. Simple as that. Generic. Yeah. You know, bringing on guys
that added to the fucking.
Yeah, apartment. Like, come on, man. Like, right. So you want all me right, to man. Say,
stop defending yourself, bro. Stop.
Nah. So what it is, it's just like, you know, sometimes people are so ignorant, you have to try your best to make it as clear as possible what you're saying. Because, yo, maybe some people did get affected by what I said, but they're taking it the wrong way. Maybe they just turned the radio on and they just heard, yo, fat bitch. They didn't hear what I said before. Some people, you know, there's mad scenarios, you know?
Yeah.
Thank God you have a replay effect, and I know you're going to rerun this show, so people will hear the whole thing. Yeah.
Who kid? Why? Who kid hates fat women? That's what it was going to be called.
Fuck, man.
We would never do you like that. It's gonna be called what happened last night. That's what it'll be called. What happened last night? Well, who kid? straight up, let's get one last call and call it 888-742-3345.
I've got Anaya in Shreveport, Louisiana.
At Shreveport, what up?
What up, though? So basically, I'm just trying to get my point of view about fat bitches cannot take the pussy. Me and my boyfriend had a threesome with a girl who was a chalupa away from being fat. She was really thick, you know, brick house type.
Yeah.
I'm smaller. I'm what you would call slim thick. I'm about, you know, 135.3. And, you know, my dude got Mandingo. The bitch could not take the dick. To save her life. I mean, she was screaming. She was hollering. She was like, I need to see how can you take it? Let me see you take it. So she sees me, you know, I got the arch in the back. You can put a champagne bottle on my shit. You know, it was in there. And I mean, from what I've heard, fat bitches cannot take dick.
Can I ask you something? Just out of curiosity. How long you been with your man?
8 years.
The first time he fucked you, did you just take all the dick the way you're taking it now, 8 years later?
Honestly, I can't take it all. I mean, I do have walls. My pussy has integrity. But, you know, I do a pretty good job. But for, you know, I like...
I'm just saying the very first time he fucked
you. I think I did a stand-up performance. Yeah, I think I did an A-plus job.
A better, but you're doing better now than you were 8 years later, I hope.
Absolutely.
All right, so cut the lady a break. You've been taking that fucking bat for 8 years, so you're a little more used to that.
But
shit.
I fucked a lot of bitches. I mean, I like thick girls. I like smaller girls, but most it's always the thicker ones that have the most problems with big dicks. It's always a thicker one. The skinny girls, I don't know how they do it, but
they take it.
They could just take dick.
I know they. Yeah, some of the best pussy I've had is on fucking these skinny chicks.
Yeah, little women take the dick.
It hugs it the whole way, and it just seems like it just goes on forever. Like they can just take the dick. It's fucking amazing.
bottomless pit. You.
Yeah, and it's giving you a nice warm hug the whole time, like here.
The internal muscles. Oh my God, that shit is like, you could come off of that.
Yeah, they really.
like a baby hand in there, just grabbing your dick. You know what I'm saying?
I've had a lot of thick chicks that fucking have, like, pussy isn't as good as you would think it's going to be. Yeah, I see, like, I'm like, ah, oh, yeah, it's fucking thick as fuck. I'm about to knock. And it's just like, ah, I wish I would have just fucked that seven. You know, like, I wish I, like, just can't take the dick.
I wish I could hear John tell a story like that. Does John goes through shit like that? Like, yo, I had her, and I put my inches in her. And
John says he's sorry before he even puts his dick in. That's the first thing he says before he puts his dick into her. He's like, I'm sorry, and then he pushes in.
I've said sorry during sex, but not in the way that you're thinking.
I'm sorry.
Well, I was maybe a little drunk and I couldn't get hard, or maybe I came too fast. Like, oh, geez, sorry. Just can we go again? How about next weekend? Can we do that next week?
You don't make them come, Joe.
What's that?
You don't make them come. You don't make them come.
Oh, yes, and we've got proof. That lady we had a couple months back, hot lady up north, came on, said I made her come. Check that out.
John didn't know that he had made her come. It was a surprise to John, but like, yeah. So yeah, John's doing the most.
I'm out there living that life.
Right now, it's Who Kid John and then me coming in last with getting fucking. I don't know if you know this shit. I got fucking vaginitis in my goddamn throat, and it fucked up, and it fucked up my vocal cords, man.
What?
So now I got to do like vocal exercises and stuff like that. Fucking crazy.
What was that? That's from the juices.
Just bad pH, fucking with shit, and then gets bacterial and stuff. And I had to take some fucking antibiotics to fix it. But it had been going on for so long because they couldn't figure out what was going on with me.
Damn, you're like that actor. Yeah. Didn't he have that? And he had like pussy cancer in his neck.
Yeah. He had Kurt Russell or Kurt Douglas. Kurt Douglas claiming he had pussy that.
Pussy neck cancer, right?
Yeah. John doesn't believe it, but like I had taking the little vaginitis pills fucking cleaned me the fuck up. But then, but it was too late. The damage had been done. I'm over here fucking having to learn how to talk again. It's fucking nerve wracking. So there it is. Yeah.
Yo, you're like a legend, man. That's some legendary shit. That's like, Mr. Playboy. That's Hugh Hefner shit right there, yo. You know what I'm saying?
The worst part about it was I was like actually trying to like be a good dude and like fucking, you know, like one woman man type shit. Wasn't fucking with nobody else. And like, and then that happened. I was like, God damn. Like the one time I'm not like fucking four different girls at once is the one time I get this shit. This is ridiculous. Fucking ridiculous. Only me. Only me.
On a side note, that's what, the other day I got in the car service, and whoever had the SUV before I got in left their Louis Vuitton purse in there. Obviously, it's a girl, and there's literally like, I mean, I was nosy, obviously. Right. Like 700 something bucks in there, right? So I'm like, damn, I should just fucking steal this shit. You know, me being a normal human, I thought I would steal it. But then, you know, I was like, fuck it. I tapped the guy. I was like, yo, I don't know who was your last client, but she obviously left her purse, all her ID, license. And then I gave the money, everything. Fucking next day, I lose my wallet and nobody found it. Like, so it's crazy.
Well, yeah, that karma shit's bullshit, bro. Don't believe that shit. Don't believe just because you give somebody your fucking thing that you're going to get your wallet back. It's the karma is you're not the kind of. You're a good dude, and you're not the kind of person that steals from somebody unnecessarily when you got enough money.
But you know, but naturally, people like when they see the money, some people think like, damn, I'm not really gonna get caught if I keep this. But then I'm like, you know what? She's probably flipping because I saw her license and everything. And so usually, if you're gonna steal money, you got to take the whole thing and then dump it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Ain't nobody trying to give them the wallet back with no cash. You know what
I'm
saying?
The other thing, too, there's a paper. Isn't there like a digital trail, like who was in the car afterwards?
And they were that's another thing, too. So
You could have been on TMZ for that.
All of us was in the car, so somebody, you know, we could just be like, no, we didn't see it. You know what I'm saying? It's not like there's a video camera inside the car, but
some keep them shits too, video cameras, to save their asses.
Shout out to where was that? That was in North Dakota. I went to the strip club. They didn't find it. I went to the only fucking what do you call them shits? The organic waffle houses, no bullshits. They didn't find it. The hotel.
Was you wearing jogs?
Yeah, I had like those Bruce Lee pants.
I stopped wearing. I stopped wearing them bitches, bro. Like you can't even enjoy yourself. Your wallet falls out every time you sit down, dog. Like, and your whole life is in that shit. I'm like, I got all these old throwback Sergio Tacchini's, and I can't even rock them motherfuckers because my wallet falls out at Echo Park. It's fucking crazy. Like, totally kills my high. Yeah.
The karma, man, let's make that clear. That karma shit is a bunch of bullshit, man. I thought I was going to be like, you know, I'm doing a good thing and good shit would come to me, man. Nothing came. Now I'm walking around with no credit cards, nothing. And I ain't trying to cut that shit because if I cut it, I'm going to be stuck out here on the road.
Right.
That's what I'm cash. You see my big cash phone? I thank God I got like thousands of dollars. I could just chill. You know what I'm saying? I can't get that shit until I get back.
Cancel it when you get back, and then you'll be all right. You're good, but it is a fucking pain in the ass. Also, what do you think? I bet you lost it at the strip club. I'm guessing.
The proof in the Instagram. I was throwing money up, jumping at whores. I was like literally flying at them. So I think it came out during that time, but
they're like, she was like, "Well, I was gonna drug him. Now I just now all I gotta do is just fucking pick it up." There it is.
But now, you know who I gotta call now, right? Who? Fucking Ron Mills, because all my Shade 4-5 IDs are in there. So it's not like they're letting people back in the building, but now I gotta go through Ron Mills and all this stupid shit. You lost every ID. It's in some bitch's pussy. Like, come on, man. I gotta hear this stupid shit.
Have fun in the Midwest. Enjoy yourself, and then have fun going out to Vegas and all those other spots where the chicks that you're used to looking at are
hot chicks.
If anybody from this show wants to party with me this Sunday in Atlantic City at HQ2, I'll put you on the list. And you could be fat, skinny. I don't give a fuck. Just come and, you know, get your swag on and turn up. Just don't be wearing no dirty ass clothes. You know, it's a fucking pool party. Come flag it up with me, man. You know what I'm saying? That's it. Boom. Bring your human being ass through and let's turn up.
Ho kid. At the end of the day, still giving out free tickets, giving out love.
You know what I'm saying? Losing wallets.
Losing wallets. We out this bitch. Let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
J45, it's the All Out Show with your boy, Judy, up in this bitch. Also, we got John Z. Matthews and Kylo Keen. What do we got coming up in the news today? What is going on? What are we talking about in the news today?
Makeup sex,
chicks liking lesbian sex and
lesbian porn,
lesbian porn, which involves sex. Watching lesbian porn. What else?
The joys of makeup sex or
makeup sex. Talking about makeup sex. Is it good, bad, indifferent? We'll let you know according to the experts. Some good news too. Don't go anywhere. Oh, yo, it's Friday. Go to alloutshow.com to grab your All Out Show gear. New shirt's up. New shirt is up. And I'm telling you, they fit like regular shirts. Even though they don't take pictures, the pictures don't look that way to some people. They do fit like regular shirts. Swaggy. Classy. Cool. Flex on them. Let them know that you're in the club. Real, recognize real. All right. Also, yeah, onemorejude.com for that. And the perfect gift for any occasion is Hummingbird. Unedited. The new edition. White cover. New story. And story. That's so grimy. Couldn't put in the first one. But it's here now. So go over there and grab that shit up. Let's play some music. Come on back.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
There's some research out looking at makeup sex. Is it actually satisfying?
That used to be my jam. I love that shit.
Love it.
But, yeah, well, tears turn me on. Ugh. I can't help that shit. It's not like that's what I was going for. I would genuinely really have a problem. And then they start crying, and then my dick would get hard, and then...
Gross.
And just, you have the fucking makeup sex.
Gross, man.
I can't help this shit. I can't help being me, John. And it's not like I didn't have a legitimate problem, like, or there wasn't a legitimate thing that we were arguing about. It wasn't like, let me make her cry so my dick could get hard. It was just be...
Right.
We'd be arguing, and then they start crying, and you start kind of feeling for them and shit, and then dick gets hard, and you make up. But sometimes they would cry, and you'd still be mad at them, so you wouldn't get the makeup sex. But if you could come to some type of, all right, I'm sorry, and then fuck.
But so you're not sabotaging the relationship to have this hot sex?
No.
No.
We were just sabotaging the relationship because we didn't know how to have relationships at the time. We were bad at it. We were bad at that shit. And then you argue, and then the tears, and then the makeup sex.
Uh-huh.
So good.
See, but that now the new research suggests it's not that good.
Well, I'm going to agree with them because I'm broken up with every girl that I fucking had to have a gang of makeup sex with. The makeup sex is bomb and shit, but like constantly arguing is probably bad is going to be my guess.
That is also true. But they're even arguing that the sex itself is not as hot as you see in the movies. That the couples... the one thing it did do, it sort of didn't decrease the sort of marital satisfaction. So it seems as though this sex after the fight kept things kind of mellow, but it wasn't really like banging sex like the movies tell us. But you're saying otherwise. You're saying it was great.
We'd always have banging sex. It was just a new type of banging sex. You know, it just, we had... good sex, and this is just a different type of it would be like eating at a nice Italian restaurant instead of a nice French restaurant that night. It would just be a new type of meal. Makeup sex meal.
This research and this paper, this makes sense to me. Yours doesn't really though. You're not really hate fucking these women or anything like that.
Nah, no. Not at all. Okay. You're not hate fucking them all. You're love fucking them. You already got the tears, so now you're trying to help them feel better. You're like, all right, shit, she's crying. Let's try to make this feel better.
And one thing they point out here is that this decent sex that people report during the makeup sex usually meant that they had already kind of smoothed things over before the sex. It's not as though, okay, fight, then sex. It was fight, and you kind of figure things out, and then you have the sex.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you got to squash it a bit. You can't fucking be fucking them and they're still mad at you for coming home late. You know what I mean? This motherfucker thinks he can just show up at 4 a.m, fucking not text me at all, nothing. Nah, it's... All right, that's how we got today. I was fucked up, And then you go.
Women preferred an apology from the partner and an emotional response such as crying. Oh boy, that's gonna be tough. Yeah. Overall, in the study, acts demonstrating emotional commitment were found to be the most effective in conflict resolution, not anal.
So there you go.
Yeah, I'm not saying it's good for the relationship. I'm just saying the shit is fucking hot. Hmm. There's lots of things that are probably bad for the relationship that are hot, you know? Fucking going to orgies all the time with your girl is probably fucking hot, but like not good for the relationship.
Oh, God. Can you imagine?
That's what I'm saying. Like, you know, you're getting to fuck a bunch of chicks, but then again, your girl's fucking a bunch of dudes. Like, it's like not, you know, it's not ideal there.
More or less to be into an orgy.
I've never been to an orgy. Well, I went to that one thing that, but it was, I went to hedonism too, but like, that was weird. I can't even call it. Like, we could do like a whole fucking thing of me going to hedonism too. That was fucking, it was weird.
People listening to the show think you're out there living that orgy life though.
I know, they think
they really do. They've actually told me that. Like, oh, yeah, well, I knew you guys were living that life. Well, first of all, I'm not, but.
Nah, I'm not living that orgy life. I mean, I've been to them. I don't even like people watching me pee. You know what I mean? I'm just like, let alone watch me fuck. Like, I'm good on that, bro. Like, nah, I'm good on that. But yeah, it's not a good looking crowd unless you're super lucky and you get, there's a couple like sex things where everybody's pretty good looking, but there's more where it's like people, there's just less good looking people. So that it, you know, there's more groups that are, have like mid range and ugly people fucking, like, it's not that hot.
No, sir.
Nah. I mean, not for me at least.
All right. So what else? Floyd Mayweather, Logan Paul, they are unfortunately fighting this weekend on Sunday.
Oh, buddy.
You can watch it.
I ain't gonna watch that shit. Hey, and you were supposed to send me some thing for my thing.
Thing for your thing.
For my Amazon shit.
I can
so
take it.
So it'll run better.
We can do that after the show. You're good. Right. You're good. I got you.
Let's do it next week. It's not. Or yeah, because now I got fucking Twitters popping up in the middle of my goddamn things.
Oh. And I gotta, loser set you up, man. Fuck out of here. I've got it. Don't worry about it. But if you want to watch this, I mean, I don't know why you would. It just seems so weird, these YouTube fights now. I just don't get it anymore. I mean, did you watch the one with his brother Jake and Ben Askren on Triller?
No.
It was just all so weird.
I don't even know who's Ben Askren.
He's an MMA guy who retired.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, yeah. No, I don't watch any of these fucking things. They're ridiculous.
They really are. I mean, there's all this hype, and then you watch it, and you're like, what was that? Was that real?
That was you getting robbed of your time and of your money. Like, I didn't watch, yo, anybody who listens to the show knows how I feel about fucking Mayweather fights. I don't know. I find them boring. Like, I appreciate all of his skill, but I want to see someone get their fucking head knocked off. Like, that's what I want to see.
I don't know if that's going to happen this weekend. I mean,
I don't think so. I'm sure the ring is going to be as big as a fucking football field, and they'll be fighting with giant pillows on their hand and
actually 12-ounce gloves. That's the rule here.
What do they usually fight with?
I mean, I think
8 to 10 ounce.
I mean, I think it's like 16 or something. I've got 16s, but 12 ounces, I think, is like mid range, but like there are no judges. There's no official winner. Knockouts.
Wait, there's no judges and no winner.
No, it's so weird. What is this? But you can knock somebody out. There is a ref, no headgear, 8 3-minute rounds. I don't even know, man.
All right, like, what size glove for heavyweights? So they're fighting with heavyweight size gloves, and neither one of them is a fucking heavyweight. That's so. Well, Paul might be. What does he weigh? He looks pretty tall.
He's certainly bigger than Mayweather. Yeah. So. Oh, I've got his height here. He's 6'2 versus Mayweather's 5'8.
Jesus Christ, that's going to be so fucking.
Well, I mean, the conventional wisdom is that what's going to happen in that first round, they're going to test each other out. And then in the second round, Mayweather's going to do some damage. And then in the third, he's going to go in and then knock Logan out.
I think he's going to do like he did, old boy, the Irishman, the cocky Irishman, McGregor. Let him punch himself out. Mayweather's got fucking, Mayweather can fight for fucking 20 rounds, dog.
Of course.
He can just fucking, he can go and go. He's Energizer Bunny, dog. He's just going to let my man punch himself out. All right, let's take a look at the stare down. Hold on one second. Oh, yeah.
God. Even that's just cringe inducing. All right, let's play that. But so they, of all course, right. doing all this build up for fight week.
Hold on one second. Let me pull it up mine too so I can be on the same page with you. All right, let's see. And is Logan the one that came on my show and...
Yes.
All right. So now they're staring at each other.
By the way, this goes on forever. So I don't know how long you can take it.
Two minutes?
It's more like 90 seconds, but...
So you're staring at each other, though they're talking. Oh, yeah. You don't want some of this. Come on, you want this.
It goes on and on.
Oh my God.
They're like... At least with the UFC, you've got Dana in there. There's no one in charge. Just these like hangers-on.
And they're going to make a fucking grip of money. Oh. And now they're like about to... Now they're damn near kissing. Jesus Christ. They're going to take their dicks out next and compare sizes. They're going to see who pissed the longest, furthest.
Oh, there's that blonde lady trying to break it up.
Yep, I'm saying now it's done. Jesus fucking Christ.
Well, when you say a grip of money, I mean, I think Mayweather, he's just getting like at least $10 million just to show up, whatever else he gets. So
yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, this is just... Man, he's just fucking picking up money, dog. He's picking up here, picking up there, picking up there. Yeah, T. Woodley, he's fighting the other Paul brother. He's a friend of our show.
So yeah.
Shout out to him. Get that money, bro. Get your fucking, get breaded. Everybody, it's like the international get breaded shit. Everything that, like, all of the fake shit that was weird, the celebrity boxing that was, like, popular in the 90s, like, as a cartoon, is now happening in real life 30 years later. Like, has-been celebrities are now fighting. These two are not has-beens. They're current, but, like, it's now it's just, like, fucking weird celebrity matches.
And I'd be frightened, really, sincerely frightened to fight either of these guys, honestly. I mean, I can't imagine what that feels like. I mean, which is a dumb thing to say, but I'll give these two brothers credit for even getting in there. This is fucking scary to me. Going up against Tyron Woodley or Floyd, yeah. I mean, you can really get hurt. But, all right, just stating the obvious.
Yeah, he could, but guy's 6'2". He's way bigger, so, you know. And Floyd's not really known as a knockout dude. He's got like tender hands, so that's good for him. So there you go. I don't know.
Right. You will not be watching though.
No. I interviewed both of them, and they were both of those interviews were. One was very popular, and the other one everyone hated. So there it is. But they were both epic in their own special ways.
All right, so it looks like there's some people looking at why straight women might prefer lesbian porn, according to sex therapists.
You know what this is for, right?
Not so much.
They're gonna try to get fucking straight guys to start watching gay porn. That's the next thing. This is just the beginning right here. They're just priming you. They're just getting your. Right now they're just fucking. They're just priming your ass. They're just playing around the butthole before the fucking sodomy. They're like, Man, let's do this study why straight women like fucking lesbian porn. All right, sweet. Next thing. Why straight guys like fucking gay watching some fucking dude get railed for fucking 5 minutes.
Well, while I appreciate your analysis, I've watched a lot of porn, and I've never, ever once sat down for some quality time with gay porn. I just, nope, no thank you.
So, yeah, the only people I want to see that's gay people, dog. I don't know any fucking straight person that's like, yo, man, let me sit down and watch some motherfucking gay porn. Except for gay dudes, you know? That's it. That's who likes gay porn, gay guys. Fucking what? All right, so why do fucking all it? Whenever y'all see shit, just think of shit as like, this is where are they gonna go with this? That's just when you start seeing these stories and stuff, don't take them as a one-off. Be like, where are they gonna go with this shit? So all right, where are you gonna go with this?
All right, so
the logical step is why straight dudes like fucking gay porn. That's totally fucking totally normal.
All right, I'll mark your words, but
well, it was the same. I called it with the fucking if you don't fuck a transgender, you're a transphobe.
You're going too far with that.
they got what? That shit. I didn't make that up. Someone else, they're saying that. Yeah.
Who's they? Who's saying
fucking,
that?
Fucking trans activists.
Well,
you didn't, dog.
Those are the outliers.
Try to start looking at different fucking news sources than just fucking your two. I swear to God. All it's right. Like, I see it on like the progressive trans sites. Like, if you're not willing to date a trans person, then you're a transphobe. It's like, I called that shit. So they're going to start saying that shit. And they did. All right. Why? How come?
This kind of makes sense. So they're saying straight porn, for the most part, sort of in taken in its aggregate here, it doesn't really address what straight women actually desire. It makes sense they look elsewhere. And so in the true lesbian porn, you got a lot of buildup, you got a lot of foreplay, a lot of action with the clitoris, some pretty heavy oral, some deep kissing. With the regular porn, it's just bang, 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 and some degrading stuff.
It is like a lot of, like, pleasing the man shit.
Yeah.
I've noticed that. It's just like, which that's not even the way I fuck. But that being said, it's just watching a dude eat a chick out is really fucking, all it is the back of a guy's head. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, I'm not really.
Like, how do you get a decent camera angle on that? Even if you do, it's like, I'm watching some guy lick a fucking clit. Like, it's not the hottest shit ever.
And a lot of guys do not agree with this, though. It's like sixth on the list of things guys like to watch, lesbian porn. And yet every porn, there's always a lesbian scene.
Yeah, I'm not crazy about lesbian. Like, the only lesbian porn I like is when they turn out the girl and make her do lesbian shit for the first time. I like the turn out porn. If they turn you out porn, that's what I like. So that's where I'm going for.
Well, if you watch true lesbian porn, as I like to think of it, sort of, I mean, it's almost as though it's made by lesbians for lesbians. It gets kind of hot. I was high a couple weeks ago, and I was watching, and I was like, whoa, okay. This is the real thing.
It's the real deal. Holyfield. All right.
Check it out.
What else?
I do have some good news.
All right, what is it?
And now, time for good news.
Okay, so there is a young man who's going into the Air Force Academy. And he had a lot of hair. This giant afro, which I'll send to you now, because... Do people still say afro? Is that still cool to say? Afro?
Well, I don't know. Fucking don't know. Call up the universities and see if you're allowed to say it. Call up some humanities professor and ask what the preferred term is for fucking afro.
I'm saying it now. Giant afro. And,
John's about to get fucking,
I don't know.
It's called fucking a fucking large fucking
helmet
large
heads.
Hair. But large hair naturality.
He's out of Alabama.
Yeah.
Kieran Moyes. And he's going, again, to the Air Force Academy. So rather than just have him shave this giant head of hair off, he and then have it fall to the floor, he had someone cut it off, and now he's donating it to this group that deals with cancer patients so they can make wigs for people.
Kick ass. Boom. Good shit. That's fucking dope. Congrats to you for going to Air Force, and thank you for fucking donating the hair and serving the country. Nice guy.
Yeah. Lots of hair.
Boy, boy. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah. All right, that's the news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, y'all. Thank you to Who Kid. Follow at DJ Who Kid. And shout out to the Midwest. All the ladies of the Midwest. Get a shout from Judy. Also, thanks to John Z. Matthews at Kylo King. Follow at All Out Show. And OneMoreJew.com. It's payday. Go blow some money. Treat yourself to some shit. All right. We're out this motherfucker. Let's go.